Hello students, in this lecture I will discuss operations on discrete time signals. In the previous lecture we have discussed the operation on continuous time signals, where we have discussed the time shifting, scaling, combined operation of shifting and scaling, time reversal. So same operations we discuss today for the discrete time signals. This is the content of the today's lecture. So we first see the time shifting in discrete domain. So similarly, continuous time signal, we have a shifting, so delayed signal, advanced signals. Then we have see the perform the time folding on discrete domain. Then time scaling operation in discrete domain, and based on that we can discuss the decimation and interpolation in discrete domains. Then if they are time scaling and time shifting operation, both the operation combined, so we apply the precedence rules whenever you have a two operation, shifting and scaling. So as per the precedence rule, we have to first shift the signal in time domain and then apply the scaling. Then mostly in a discrete domain you have integers, the period is an integer, so samples at integers, so n equal, you have n discrete values, so most of the delays is a integer values, but in some of the case you require a delay is a fractional delays. So how to compute the fractional delays in discrete domains, so that we'll discuss here. Then after that we'll discuss sketch the waveforms of the signals in discrete and continuous domains, and also we can express the waveform as a sum of unit step function, or maybe you can also represent a ramp function, or and also examples based on all the operation listed here. So this is the content of the today's lecture. Thank you students.